Good morning, students. In this video, we are going to solve a problem asked in the GATE 2015 paper. This problem is about calculating the power of a signal g of t, which is expressed in terms of x of t with this expression, and the x of t waveform given like this. So we need to find the power of g of t. That means first we need to find the power of x of t. From this relation, we can find the power of g of t. Then first recall the power changes whenever the signal x of t is shifted or scaled. If x of t power is p, then x of t minus t naught shifted version power is same power p. If it is scaled by k, then the power is p by k. And here g of t is given in terms of x of t like this. X of t minus 1 whole divided by 2. I am writing like this, x of 1 by 2 t minus 1 by 2. So that this is shifting constant, this is scaling constant. So whenever signal x of t is shifted, there is no change in power. If signal is scaled by k, then the original power is divided by the scaling constant k. That means this signal total power is nothing but x of 1 by 2 t power. This is nothing but g of t power. If we write like this, this is nothing but x of kt here, k value 1 by 2, x of t power p, x of kt power p by k. That means I am taking x of t power p, so p divided by k value is 1 by 2. That is nothing but 2 times the power of x of t. So let us add a suffix here. So, if you find the power of this x of t as per the given waveform, then double that of power is nothing but the required signal power g of t. This one. First, let us calculate the power of this periodic signal. So, the power formula for a periodic signal is 1 by tau with the limit tau tending to infinity or capital T, you can take t tending to infinity 1 by t minus t by 2 to plus t by 2 x of t magnitude square. This is what the power formula for a given signal, periodic signal especially. Here t stands for time period of the given signal. Here what is the time period of the given signal means? This signal repeats. This is the time period. Over this cycle the signal repeats. That means 3 is the time period here. T value is 3. And here if you substitute that values, limit t tending to infinity 1 by 3 and minus t by 2 is minus 1.5 to plus 1.5, x of t expression over this interval. That means minus 1.5 to plus 1.5 over this interval, we need to integrate the signal. In this interval, signal is 0 from minus 1.5 to minus 1 and 1 to 1.5. And it is non-zero over the interval minus 1 to plus 1. So we can change these limits from minus 1 to plus 1. So over that interval, the non-zero waveform we are seeing, this signal is nothing but, if you take this signal, the amplitude is minus 3 to plus 3. This signal is nothing but 3t. So that this signal is reflection of that signal. So this should be minus 3t. So this is the waveform equation here. Minus 3t. So minus 3t whole square dt. So this is the power of the given signal x of t. We need to simplify this one. Let us take it. Limit t tending to infinity 1 by 3. This is minus 3 whole square 9. Let us take it outside of this integration. And this is t square integration. That is t cube by 3 with the t limits minus 1 to plus 1. Right. Further simplification, limit t tending to infinity. Here 3 into 3, this 9 cancels. So that this is 1 cube minus of minus 1 whole cube. Here there is no t t to substitute t tending to infinity. So in this expression, total constant is there, no capital T. So we can negotiate this one. And here the remaining expression is 1 cube minus minus 1 whole cube. This is 1 plus 1, 2. This is 2 watts power for the given signal x of t. And we need to calculate the power of g of t, which is 2 times the power of x of t. So the power of g of t is 2 times the power of x of t, that is 2 into this 2, 4 watts power is the required power of g of t. Thank you.